You've got to track him down and get that egg! Run! Run! I'm getting a little winded.
So I can listen to what he says again. Oh, that's the guy in blue, I guess. The last game I played was Twilight Princess, where it was like, well, I changed it like this because I was used to it for that game. I guess I'm still used to it now. It was probably like this on PlayStation. That was, they inverted things like by default back then. How did I not make it up there? My feet were clearly above it. Thank you.
Thank you for releasing me, Spyro. You can always check your progress by accessing the guidebook through the pause menu.
Catch that guy. I might have done everything here. I think. To go down there and try to hit him, he's just gonna like jump all the way up and come back here like he did before. I can combine trying to chase him with this and get extra distance with the flame breath, because you can't do it while charging. Actually need some kind of upgrade or something. And come back here, be able to catch him. Go! Why did he already leave? Actually got him that time, I guess. Okay, so this is where I started out, right? I thought there was another way to get out of here, back here, but I guess it's just at the end that exists. those really have to take that long still? Like, I've seen this and the original, like, speedrun at GDQ. Wasn't really paying attention, because I can rarely end up paying attention to a game I haven't played and can't follow what's going on. But often I find myself looking over to Spyro gliding through the air in that loading screen. Just a few short blips of gameplay and then more of that. Something like the portal speedrun with the elevators. Though not as bad. I think they'd be able to shorten the load times after all this time. No charge, no fire, no bolt. Definitely need some kind of upgrade. Get into that.
Watch the dragonfly, Spyro. His color indicates his power. When he eats butterflies, he stays strong. Like me.
It's amazing that they aren't disorientated and they can just get back to whatever they were in the middle of doing. Once I break him out of their petrified form, he just pours himself a cup of whatever that was. Like he was never, you know, turned into a statue or anything.
Spyro, my friend, how about a hint on gliding?
You bet!
For the longest glide, press the jump button at the top of your jump, and try pressing the action button to drop down mid-flight.
You're too late. Someone else already told me that. basically some guy who stole a dragon egg in every level. Constantly taunting me.
You've freed all the dragons. Pass through this fancy vortex thingamajigger. It'll take you back to the artisan home. But first, let me tell you a story.
No thanks. See ya!
I'd rather listen to the story than... a bunch of gameplay tips that are pretty obvious without any dragon telling me them. What's this? What's this key? What's this about? While to come up, huh?
When you free a dragon or step on one of their platforms, you're saving your progress. That could be useful if you run into trouble. Not that you ever run into trouble, Spyro.
I actually didn't know that one. Step on the platform, huh? So, her magic wanding me like that is a saving, I guess. Get up to that guy. It's almost like these higher areas are disguised as some place that you'd think might be out of bounds. So I thought I might be able to get up here, but I thought maybe I could get up with the vortex and then gliding over here, but no. That's knocking me away? I thought I was hitting it and causing it. This is a out of bounds barrier. This is like, these are the repeaters that allow the